Prabhakar. I've been shooting with SIA for like last 4 months.
Oh, okay.
So today I learned like a panning shot. I saw these photos earlier, but I don't know how to take these pictures.
Okay.
But today it's helped me to learn this technique.
Okay, so can you tell us what settings you used for panning?
Panning, I use like 1/50 shutter speed.
Okay.
The remaining settings are auto. Shutter speed is priority.
So 1/50 shutter speed and ISO is on auto, and we are using the AFC or AI servo mode in your camera.
Continuous,
right? And then you have to lock the focus on the subject and move it along with the subject.
Yep. The technique I learned it. So took few interesting photos.
Okay, great.
Thank you.
Okay, what about you, Sobhan?
Yeah, my name is Sobhan, and today we learned this is the first time I am doing panning photography.
Oh, this is the first time? Oh,
first
okay.
time, and
okay.
I shot some really good pictures.
Okay.
So, settings I am using for this, it's a shutter priority mode, and it's one of 50 of a second, and rest of the settings are same.
Yeah.
And another, we took some good temple picture also.
Yeah, so temple pictures, we saw some pictures look very dramatic when you have some kind of action. Okay, and things like only the statues make a very boring picture, but when you have some subject there, some human element, they always add some more value to the picture.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, what about you?
Hi, I'm Ravi. Started taking pictures, I mean, with my DSLR since last 3 to 4 months.
Mm-hmm.
So I've attended a couple of classes by SIA Photography, and today I've learned about panning. So in TV mode, so basically shutter priority mode with a 1/50, and then with AF servo mode, and managed to get at least 2 or 3 good pictures.
Yeah. So initially, when you are trying for the first time, maybe you have to do a little bit of trial and error, but maybe at a later point of time, you will just do one shot and then you will get it right. Okay, so just one shot and you will get it right. That's it.
Yeah, and then I try to actually take some architecture photography from the temple.
Okay.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay.
Hi, I'm Srita, and this is my first photo work.
Okay. So this is the first time you are coming?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
The last time I missed.
Uh-huh.
And this is my first pan shots.
Mm-hmm.
And I learned to take the perspective instead of just capturing the image.
Mm-hmm.
So, and temple shots are also good.
Okay. So also when we are doing panning, you also have to be observant about the light. So whatever photography you are doing, you have to be little observant about light. You see, the moment light started coming in, you started getting shadows, and that really makes a lot of difference to the pictures, right? So also when you are shooting a temple, what direction would be good? So if I am shooting against the light, that is a very difficult situation to take a picture. So you can go that side and take a picture, the other side. But if you really want to take a picture only the side, what is the solution we talked about?
Bracketing.
Yeah, you can do bracketing.
Okay, bracketing.
So, yeah, so you can do 3 or more shots and then combine them into one shot. So if you use Lightroom, you have this in the photo menu, you have photo merge, and then you have then HDR. So when you go to that HDR and you just browse for this file, you will be able to do everything. So you don't have to do anything, the software will do it for you. Okay, so it does a pretty good job. Okay, thank you, Srikant. I hope you enjoyed.
Yeah, I enjoyed.
Okay, what about you?
Hi, I'm Zaina. This is my start. It's just my second photo walk, and I learned the shutter mode, how to pan mode, and yeah, thank you, sir. I got good show.
Okay, great.
I'm Srinivas. I've been attending several photo walks with Saurabh. Today we learned panning. I did panning before, but not very successful. But today I'm glad I got very good clicks. I think I need to practice more.
Okay.
Overall, several photos were attended as well, wonderful
learning
experience.
Great.
So, hello,
sir.
This was my first time taking panning photos, so
okay.
It was fun. So I learned a lot. Plus also I learned about a few more interesting things like composition, how to create the sense of depth and all.
Mm-hmm.
I saw some pictures where like added elements make it dramatic. So that was fun.
Mm-hmm.
Plus that bracketing also was good learning.
Okay. And some of you had less space in your memory card. So always make sure that you empty out your card before you join for any walk. So, and I'm embarrassed to say, but I have been in situations where there is something very interesting going on and I don't have memory with me, and I'm wasting time deleting pictures. So that is the worst thing that you can do. So always make sure that you, when you join for any session, you empty out your card, format your card, and then join for the class.
Do you carry extra memory cards?
Yeah, all the time. Whenever I'm shooting, you have to get. But again, that depends on what you are shooting. Say suppose I have a 32 GB memory card which will take about 500 pictures. I am sure that during the next 2-3 hours, I'm not going to take more than 500 pictures. So which is okay. But sometimes when I shoot festivals or dance, now dance means a lot of pictures. I mean, you are going to shoot mostly in the bus mode. So that is where, you know, or when I'm shooting a festival, that again means a huge amount of pictures. So that is where you have to carry a lot of memory cards, because if you finish in the middle of the thing, so whenever you are doing any event or festival, you have to do that. Okay, what about you?
Hi, I'm Pulkit. Apart from panning, the thing I like the most was bracketing. Because there've been a lot of times when I've taken a photo against the sunlight and
right.
part of the photo is underexposed and the other part is overexposed.
Right.
So I think this will be a...
Yes, so bracketing really helps, especially for landscape photographers where... or when you shoot a sunset picture, you will see they always will be like this. The sun part will be too bright and the other part will be too dark, right? So this is what you have to do. You have to do three shots and then stitch them into one picture. So very, very easy to do in Photoshop or Lightroom. Very, very easy to do. Okay. So any questions that you have on whatever we did today? Any questions? Good learning. Okay. Okay, great. Then thank you so much for joining.
I have one question.
Yeah.
Like, what's the difference between a good panning photo and a great panning photo?
Okay. So we have a question. Pulkit is asking, what is the difference between a good panning photo and a great panning photo? So what could be your answer?
That should also be an example. We got the elements right.
Exactly. So we have a picture. So you got that picture, right?
Four members.
Yeah. So we all got good panning shot. But an outstanding panning shot will be the choice of your subject. So there were five people in a bike and they were all having fun.
Four people.
No, I think yours was just five.
Five.
And they all were smiling. There were some girls also and they all were smiling. It's like they are having fun on a Sunday morning. Yeah. So that makes a great panning shot. So your choice of subjects. So that really makes a lot of difference.
I was lucky.
Yeah. So you are lucky because you are here. Okay. So that's the thing. So, but yeah, you just have to wait and you will get something like that. Okay. So any other questions that you have?
Thank you.
So that was a good question actually. Yeah. Okay. So, okay then. Thank you so much for joining me.
Apart from this particular class, one question is, how do I take the start trails? I mean, I've got the remote and then I know that it has to be taken in a bulk mode. But I'm not so sure.
No, you don't have to take it in the bulb mode. You have to use 30 seconds.
Okay.
Just 30 seconds and widest opening. And but from the city, it is difficult.
Okay.
If you are going to a far away place, because in the city, we don't see stars. Hardly any one or two stars you will be able to see. So you have to go out of the city, drive at least 100 kilometers. And then you will be able to see stars very clearly.
In that scenario, I tried that, but it was not able to focus properly.
Okay, focus, autofocus will not work. You have to use manual focus. So you just have to put your camera on the manual focus and put it to the infinity side. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so put it to the infinity side and you will be able to, the camera will be able to.